Welcome back, everyone. Thank you for your patience. So, the Committee on Standards and Ethics opened a meeting earlier today regarding a pending disciplinary matter initiated pursuant to Section 10.80 of the Council Rules concerning Councilmember Barry Grudenchik. Because it was necessary for the committee to discuss confidential personnel issues in conjunction with the pending disciplinary matter, the committee voted to move into executive session pursuant to Article 7 of the Public Officers Law. We are now returning to open session to make public the outcome of today's vote regarding the pending disciplinary matter. I'm again joined by Council Members Gibson and Chin. Based upon a thorough and wide-ranging investigation conducted by both the Council's Office of the General Counsel and the Special Counsel retained by the committee to prosecute this disciplinary proceeding, the committee voted today to issue two charges against Council Member Grudenchik. The charges state that from 2017 until early 2019, the council member engaged in certain conduct that was based upon the complainant's gender that caused the complainant to be discriminated against and harassed in the workplace. The charged conduct found by the committee to have occurred would stand as a violation of council policy and council rule 10.80. The committee will hold a disciplinary hearing on these charges on May 13, 2019, beginning at 10 a.m. The hearing will be held in executive session, and Councilmember Grudenchik has a right to be represented by counsel at the hearing. The council has hired Carrie Cohen to serve as special counsel and present the case against Councilmember Grudenchik to the committee. While the proceedings are confidential, after the committee deliberates on the charges, the findings and recommendations of the committee will be made public. In addition to this action concerning Councilmember Grudenchik, the committee reviewed a report of preliminary inquiry concerning allegations of misconduct by Councilmember Andy King. The allegations against Councilmember King include engaging in sexual harassment, permitting an associated person, spouse, to perform council business, creating a work environment where her spouse was permitted to engage in harassment of a council employee, allegations that Councilmember King created an environment where an employee in his office with supervisory responsibilities repeatedly threatened violence in the office and at work functions, and on at least one occasion, the employee committed an act of violence against a subordinate employee. Finally, there are allegations of numerous instances of misuse of city resources. Despite many attempts to interview Councilmember King about these allegations, he has refused to cooperate with the investigation and only made himself available for 5 minutes to discuss a separate but related investigation into one of his staff members. In light of the committee's review of a preliminary investigation into the allegations against Councilmember King and Councilmember King's refusal to cooperate with the committee, the committee voted to commence disciplinary proceedings against Councilmember Andy King. The next steps are for the special counsel to review the committee's report, conduct further investigation as necessary, and make a recommendation of charges, if any, to this committee. This concludes our summary of the committee's votes during today's meeting. This meeting is now adjourned. Thank you all for coming.